They're set. The gates open. Walkover from the inside was the first to actually bounce out of the gates, but taken on very quickly here on the outside by Call to War. And Call to War, being bustled around the outside, goes to the lead. Into stride quickly, Alert Bird firing up Pigeon Post, racing a little keenly down on the inside shortly after the start. Stokewood's up handier to them. Then came Garnish, who settled over on the inside from Pick Jam, a gap of 2.5 lengths to Cape Fear. A similar margin then to Cash Machine, who'd got well back with Hollywood Land, and tailing out a long last after getting out okay as Walkover. As they work to the turn off the back straight, they've got about 950 to go, and the leader is Call to War. The favourite on top, led Pigeon Post, the lightweight, doing all of the chasing. 3 lengths behind them, Alert Bert. Getting up on the inside now to fourth is Garnish, and then came Stokewood, who just wanted to labour there and drop the bit. He has to stoke him up again. A length away behind them, Pick Jam coming around heels, looking to get to the outside from Cape Fear the Grey. And they're followed further back by Hollywood Land, down on the inside of Cash Machine. Walkover is stopping to a walk as they come up to the corner with about 400 left to go. And around the bend, Call to War straightened up, two clear from Pigeon Post. Down on the inside, Garnish, Hollywood Land tracking through, Pick Jam, Cape Fear, Stokewood again picks up the bit with Alert Bird at the head of the others. Down past the 250, Call to War showing the persuader from Pigeon Post. Stokewood runs on, still Call to War, 100 left to go from Pigeon Post. Stokewood, Pick Jam running on now. Call to War the leader. Pigeon Post keeps coming, so does the Post, and it's too late. And Call to War held off Pigeon Post. Pick Jam third from Cape Fear, Stokewood. Behind them, Garnish, Hollywood Land. At the head of the others was Cash Machine. Alert Bird second from last. And Walkover was always... They're set. The gates open. Walkover from the inside was the first to actually bounce out of the gates, but taken on very quickly here on the outside by Call to War. And Call to War, being bustled around the outside, goes to the lead. Into stride quickly, Alert Bird firing up Pigeon Post, racing a little keenly down on the inside shortly after the start. Stokewood's up handier to them. Then came Garnish, who settled over on the inside from Pick Jam, a gap of 2.5 lengths to Cape Fear. A similar margin then to Cash Machine, who'd got well back with Hollywood Land, and tailing out a long last after getting out okay as Walkover. As they work to the turn off the back straight, they've got about 950 to go, and the leader is Call to War. The favourite on top, led Pigeon Post, the lightweight, doing all of the chasing. 3 lengths behind them, Alert Bert. Getting up on the inside now to fourth is Garnish, and then came Stokewood, who just wanted to labour there and drop the bit. He has to stoke him up again. A length away behind them, Pick Jam coming around heels, looking to get to the outside from Cape Fear the Grey. And they're followed further back by Hollywood Land, down on the inside of Cash Machine. Walkover is stopping to a walk as they come up to the corner with about 400 left to go. And around the bend, Call to War straightened up, two clear from Pigeon Post. Down on the inside, Garnish, Hollywood Land tracking through, Pick Jam, Cape Fear, Stokewood again picks up the bit with Alert Bird at the head of the others. Down past the 250, Call to War showing the persuader from Pigeon Post. Stokewood runs on, still Call to War, 100 left to go from Pigeon Post. Stokewood, Pick Jam running on now. Call to War the leader. Pigeon Post keeps coming, so does the Post, and it's too late. And Call to War held off Pigeon Post. Pick Jam third from Cape Fear, Stokewood. Behind them, Garnish, Hollywood Land. At the head of the others was Cash Machine. Alert Bird second from last.